Hi, everybody. Dan Ullman, Mike Beer of the DRF Race of the Day for Sunday, February the 3rd. Race number 7 at Aqueduct. It's the Busanda Stakes for 3-year-old fillies going the demanding mile and an eighth. Let's take a look at this field. You can access free Formulator Pass performances for this race on the Race of the Day event page at DRF.com. Download them, handicap along with us. Who knows? Maybe a Kentucky Oaks filly or two will come out of the Busanda. Let's see what the Timeform US pace projector has to say about this race. You'll note the blue bar, which in Timeform US parlance indicates that this race will favor horses on or near the early lead. The 3 Quality Heat blinkers on, the 4 Persisto. They're expected to be close. If I had to choose between the two, I would choose the latter.
Yeah, sure. I won't argue with that. I don't expect anybody to be out there blazing on the lead. So we'll just see how it all plays out.
Number 1, Water White, was a winner 2 starts back, and I kind of liked the way she won that race. She was rated back to track the pace inside. She angled out and turning into the stretch, I really thought she'd win by 5. And it looked like she was hanging and hanging and hanging, and she might have been a little bit lucky to win that race. In the Demoiselle, though, she just really had no chance, breaking from post position 9 the way the track was playing.
Yeah, true enough. I mean, you know, the good thing about her is that she's already run fast. She ran an 80 buyer in her 2nd career start. You know, as opposed to you, I did not like her maiden win. Just a race where it looked like she was supposed to win easily. And as it turns out, she had to work really, really hard to get it done. But she did get it done in that race. And then last time, I mean, I would just throw the Demoiselle out. Manny Franco breaking from the outside. I'm not sure why he didn't want to go, but he just took her in hand and got her caught wide all the way around the first turn, lost all kinds of position. That effort is really not as bad as it looks on paper.
Not at all. And she has valuable experience at the distance with that race under her girth. Water White, 5-2 on the morning line, certainly fits this race on figs. And again, draws a nice inside post. Ankle Monitor, the 2, ships up from Laurel. She's won 4 of 8 starts for trainer Claudio Gonzalez, including this race over Muddy Going. This is a 1-turn mile. She is on the outside. She is 3-5. She has to work really hard to beat 3 other horses in here. I think she's a very honest, consistent filly. I am very concerned about the mile and an eighth.
Yeah, I'm concerned about the mile and eighth too. I mean, maybe this race here, just to, you know, give her the benefit of the doubt, maybe she just didn't really like the wet track, but I mean, she's life and death to get it done here at a short price. And she just doesn't look like a horse who wants to go much longer than that mile right there.
Quality Heat is stakes placed on turf. She is stakes placed on dirt. She's getting blinkers from Mark Cassie after a 3rd place finish last time out over a wet track. She's actually yet to try fast going in her career. I look at this pedigree and, Mike, you know, I have a feeling maybe she'll get this 9.
Yeah, I'm not worried about distance with her at all. I think she is bred to stretch out. I guess my real problem with her, Dan, is I don't like either of her dirt races. And I don't see why I would take her over the horse that just beat her last time, because Truth Hurts ran a lot better than she did in that race.
Persisto, the 4, has been beaten by several of these horses. And then she came back last time out and she faced none of these horses. And well, it worked to Persisto's favor as the 11-10 favorite. Let's watch that race. Lime Green Silks. Dylan Davis takes over the lead with Persisto for trainer Kelly Breen. She's off to the races. 75 buyer speed figure is a career best. I'm not worried about distance. She's by Orb out of a Warfront mare. She seems to be improving with each and every start, and I do like the fact that she can get forward.
Yeah, I like that too. I mean, there are things to like about her. She took a little bit of a step forward in this race right here and won it pretty nicely. Maybe she can improve again, especially if the pace isn't fast and she makes the lead.
Truth Hurts, the number 5, goes out for our buddy Chad Summers. This horse is 2-for-2, including a win and a non-winners of 1 other than last time out, going the 1-turn mile. Let's watch that race right now. Like the way she splits horses. She's in the salmon cap. Splits them nicely right here and then goes about her business. Didn't think this was the strongest field in the world, but you and I have been waiting for the tonalists to stretch out, and now Truth Hurts gets a chance to go a mile and an eighth.
Yeah, it's interesting. You know, she's run well in both of her starts. When she won first time out at a big price, I mean, she looked like a horse who maybe didn't really want to sprint, but she was game to run down a favorite on the lead. And she was pretty impressive winning last time. Listen, the horse she ran down, the favorite there, Autonomous, the Chad Brown horse, she's not very good. And this is a tougher spot for Truth Hurts. But I don't know, Dan, I like both of her races. I think she's interested in here.
Harvey's little goyle went turf to dirt for Bill Mott to graduate most recently on December the 12th. Like the way she did it. She's tracking the pace inside as they turn into the stretch. She's the gray. She's going to have to alter horse off heels to get to the three path. And once she does and she gets optimal clearance, she's off to the races, even though she's looking at us right now.
Yeah, she was sort of gawking at the stands there. This is a pretty impressive dirt debut, though. I feel like it took a lot of money in that race, too. Like, people knew she was going to run when they switched surfaces. Her turf debut, not as bad as it looks. She had things going against her in that race. She really looked good winning her dirt debut. I think it makes her tough right back.
And she's built up the frequent flyer miles after that win at Aqueduct. Three works at Payson, right back up to New York for her stakes debut. 50 Shades of Green has won around two turns. That was a mile and 70-yard race at Monmouth. We'll watch it right now. This is way back on October the 13th, and she is on the outside. And this Bernardini filly really bred for distance in the two turns. No surprise that she handles it. She beats Persisto, who finishes second in this race. Gets a little drifty in the lane, but I like how John Service has handled this one. 50 Shades of Green, nice mile breeze, getting her ready for a mile and an eighth off the layoff.
Yeah, I like that win from her right there, too. Around two turns, she carried all the ground in that race. Didn't save an inch and still finished it off pretty nicely at the end. She seems like a horse who really wants to stretch out.
Top pick time for the Sunday race of the day, the $100,000 Busanda. We're both going with Harvey's little goyle. We liked the way she was able to show some agility turning into the stretch and get to the outside and then run away from those horses. She's a daughter of American Pharoah. We're not worried about the distance. I'm going 6417. You're going 6517. Truth Hurts at a price for second.
I want to use that horse. I think she's been okay in both of her races, and she's probably going to be a price again, Dan. We'll see what happens with Harvey's little goyle. I'm not, you know, I don't love her, but I do think it's probably a pretty good spot for her to stretch out.
Race number 7 at the Big A, the Busanda, has an approximate post time, 4:25 Eastern. Best of luck.